Welcome to Gourmet Kitchen. Today I'm making turkey meatballs, another of our family favorites. I love making these. They are so easily adaptable as appetizers or with spaghetti and marinara sauce, and they freeze really well for a good 2 months or so. I always have them in my freezer. So first I'm gonna start out by heating some oil and butter together. This is 93% lean turkey meat, so it's going to need some additional fat so that the meatballs can come together. I'm going to put in my chopped onions and brown them really well. The onions are ready in about 5 to 8 minutes on medium-high heat. I'm going to add in my ginger garlic paste and cook the ginger and garlic until the raw smell is completely gone. I'm going to lower the heat now and start adding the salt, black pepper, cumin powder, and a pinch of Kitchen King masala for a little curry flavor. This is completely optional, but I love that little zing that the masala brings. I'm also going to add in the breadcrumbs at this point and roast them for about 5 to 10 minutes on very low heat. Once the bread mixture is ready, I'm going to let it cool for about 30 minutes. And then add in to the meat. Along with the bread mixture, I'm also adding a teaspoon of garlic powder to enhance the garlic flavor of these meatballs. Now I'm going to gently but thoroughly mix everything together. Remember to be gentle, we don't want the meatballs to be tough. And I'm going to now use a tablespoon size cookie scoop to form these meatballs. Using a scoop actually helps keep the meatball sizes uniform, and the 2.5 pounds of meat that I'm using will give me about 40 meatballs. Now the frying part is easy. Take a little bit of oil, heat it up on medium heat, and then remembering not to overcrowd the pan, we are going to put in the meatballs one at a time and start frying them. Remember the sides of the meatball, remember to cook them uniformly from all sides. I still see a little bit of pink, so this entire frying procedure is going to take about 20 minutes on medium heat. Covering them with the lid and tossing them around in the pan helps them cook uniformly and cook through and through. Because this is meat, I am going to use my thermometer to check if the meatballs are ready. I'm looking for a temperature above 165 degrees Fahrenheit. So they are ready. I'm seeing 180 degrees. I'm going to use a paper towel here to soak up the excess oil from the meatballs. And then serve them up with a little marinara sauce. Enjoy!
Don't forget to like and subscribe and download our app from the App Store or Google Play.